When you first start writing code, you may end up with programs that look like this. This is a C++ program that I've worked with in previous videos that defines a function named determineAreaRect that'll just determine the area of a simple rectangle. And while this program works, what we want to do is build more toward working with classes in C++, being it is an object-oriented language. In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to take a program like this and turn it into a nice, neat class definition. Let's first give it a run through and see exactly what this program does. If you're not sure what's going on in this code, you should probably go back in my previous tutorials and make sure you understand how to write a C++ program, how to define a C++ function, and what function prototypes are. Let's take a look at this program and see what it does. Just allows the user to enter in the length and the width. And once the user does that and then press enter, the program will output the area of the simple rectangle. Now let's change this program to where it's defined within a class. The first thing you want to do is define the class wrapper. So in C++, the way you define a class is use the keyword class, and then you need to provide an identifier name for that class. I'm just going to name my class Rectangle. The data that goes inside that class declaration goes inside curly brackets, and you got to remember to end the class declaration with a semicolon. Now I'm going to go in and define my private and public members. A couple things to remember is your class definition has to live within your curly brackets, and don't forget your semicolon at the end of the last curly bracket. Now what I'm saying in this class definition or declaration is that I've got two private data members, one variable for the width and one for the length, and then my public are references to the different functions that will live inside of this class. I've got setWidth, setLength, getWidth, and getLength. These are my accessors and mutators, also known as set and get functions. Now I'm ready to go ahead and define setWidth. And what setWidth is going to do when it's called, it's going to assign a value to our private data member width. And you can see that we define this function in the same way with one exception. Notice we've got our added scope to our rectangle class definition. This is important because we're defining this particular function or these sets of functions, which we'll have in a minute, within the same file as our class definition. Now I'm ready to define my function setLength, which is going to assign a value to the length. So now that I have my set functions defined, I'm ready to go ahead and define my get functions. Remember, your set functions are your mutators and your get functions are your accessors. So there's getWidth, and what it's going to do is just return whatever value lives in our width data member. Now I'm ready to write getLength. Now that I have my functions declared, so I've got my setWidth, setLength, getWidth, and getLength, I'm ready to write a main function that's going to test this and make sure that everything is working correctly. So I go ahead and define main in the traditional way. And then the first thing that I need to do inside the body of main is to declare an instance of our rectangle class. I'm going to name the instance of the rectangle class myRectangle. Now the next thing I want to do is go ahead and declare local variables for the length and the width. And I'm just going to name them lLength and lWidth for local length and local width. And just because I like to always go ahead and initialize my variables, even if I don't have to, I'm going to go ahead and initialize both of those guys to zero. The next thing I want to do is take in input from the user. I want to find out what What is the width and length that the user wants to work with? All right, so here's my prompt asking the user for the width and the length. And now I'm ready to write my CN call that's going to store that in my local variables, LLength and LWidth. So the next step is going to be to take the length and width, the local data, and store it into our myRectangle object. So to do that, we just need to call myRectangle. And we're going to use our mutator set. What are we working with first? Length. And what we're going to work with on set length will be, we're passing it L length. And we're going to do the same thing for the width. And so now what we have is our prompt for the length and the width. And we're loading that data up into our myRectangle object. The next step is going to be to allow our class definition to and our functions to compute that data, and then we're going to output the data back out to the user. All right, so now that we've taken our local variables and initialized our members with that data, now we're ready to output information based upon the information that the user has input. First thing we're doing is just simply outputting the rectangle's length based upon what the user inputted. Notice we're reaching up into our object and get length to grab that data. Then we're outputting the rectangle's width by just spitting out the data that the user entered. And then in this last step, we're outputting the area of the rectangle. Notice again, we're using our accessors or our get functions to grab that data that lives up inside our private member functions to calculate the area of the rectangle. So let's take a look one more time at this overall program and make sure we understand exactly what's going on. The first thing we did was declare the class. And what we said when we declared our class rectangle is that we've got two private data members, width and length. And then we have four public members, and they are our set width function, set length function, get width, and get length function. Then we went on down to define those functions. Notice the use of scope, since we've got this all defined within the same file. And our set width is just going to take in whatever the user entered down below and assign that data to our private data member. Set length works in exactly the same way, only working with different data, of course. Our get width and get length functions just reach up into those private data members and return that data from wherever that function is being called from. And then in main, we're just testing it. So we're prompting the user for what is the length and the width, and we're storing that data inside local variables, LLength and LWidth. We're then populating the length and width private data members by using our set functions, set length and set width. Remember, your set functions are also called mutators. And the argument, of course, we're passing in this case is L length, and then the second argument is L width. Then when we're ready to output the data, this is just a standard output, but notice that we're outputting the data that lives inside our get length, or we're using get length function to output the data that lives inside our private length data member. Same thing for width. And then in this last output statement, we're simply using our accessors or our get functions, and we're calculating the area of the rectangle based upon what's returned. This tutorial helps you understand the definition of a class in C++ and how accessors and mutators, or set and get functions, help us to work with the data that might be defined within our private data members.